हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आईटीएलएस एकेडमी। द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर इज कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ स्टेम सेल मार्कर्स, बट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर वी विल सी सम मार्कर्स दैट आर कॉमनली यूज्ड टू आइडेंटिफाई स्टेम सेल एंड टू कैरेक्टराइज डिफरेंशिएटेड सेल टाइप्स। In our previous lecture of stem cell markers, we have seen that what are markers, what are stem cell markers, and how these markers are used for the identification of various kinds of stem cells. We have also seen some properties of markers and the very important technique, that is fluorescence activated cell sorting, we have discussed. So let us start with our today's lecture, and we will see some characterized differentiated cell types and various markers that are commonly used for the identification purpose. So here we are starting with various markers. In the first column, here is marker name, next one is cell type, and other is significance. So first of all, we are going to see various kinds of markers that are present in nervous system. So very first marker is CD133. This CD133 is present in neural stem cell and hematopoietic stem cell. Neural stem cells are responsible for the formation of nervous system, while the hematopoietic stem cells are responsible for the formation of a blood circulatory system. The significance of these markers, that is the CD133 marker, is this is cell surface protein that identifies the neural stem cells which give rise to neurons and glial cells. Coming to our next marker, that is glial fibrillary acidic protein, in short it is known as GFAP. I want to tell you all one thing, that these markers are most of the time these are written in their short form. Short form is always preferred over the long form or their full name. So this GFAP marker is present in astrocyte, and if we talk about the significance, so the significance is the protein is specifically produced by the astrocytes. Our next marker given here is MAP2 or microtubule associated protein 2. This marker is present in neurons. The significance of this marker is this is dendrite specific MAP. This is dendrite specific MAP protein found specifically in dendritic branching of neuron. The next type of marker is MPB or myelin basic protein. This MPB is present in oligodendrocytes, and the significance is that this MPB is protein produced by mature oligodendrocyte, that these are kind of cells that are present in our nervous system. and these are located in the myelin sheath or surrounding neuronal structure. What is myelin sheath? I hope you all know what is the structure of a neuron. This is the axon of neuron, and on the axon some fat coverings are present, and these coverings are known as myelin sheath. Between myelin sheath sometimes gaps are present, not sometimes, it is always these gaps are present, and these are known as node of Ranvier's. The next marker is nestin, and this is present on the neural progenitors. The significance of nestin is that this is intermediate filament structural protein expressed in primitive neural tissues. This is not present in newly formed neural tissues. This is present in primitive neural tissues. Next one marker is neural tubulin. This is present in neuron, and the significance is that this is important structural protein for a neuron, and this identifies differentiated neurons. What are differentiated neurons? This is a neuron, and this differentiate into various other types of neurons. This is known as differentiated neurons, and the protein or marker present is neural tubulin. Next marker is NF or neurofilament, that is again present on the nervous system or neuron. Significance again is same, that is important structural protein for a neuron and identifies differentiated neuron. Next marker is a neurosphere, and this is present on the embryoid bodies or embryonic stem cells. Embryoid bodies are a type that are developed from this embryonic stem cell. The significance of this marker is these are the cluster of primitive neural cells in culture of differentiating embryonic stem cells, and this indicates presence of early neuron and glia. Coming to next marker, that is noggin, and guys, this is a very important marker. Noggin and some upcoming markers like OCT4 and many more are very important. I will star mark all the important markers, and you have to remember all those markers. So this noggin is present on the neurons, and the significance is that this is a neuron specific gene expressed during the development of neuron. This noggin is responsible for the development. This is very important term, noggin, OCT4, and we will see various other kinds of molecules that are responsible for the development. Next one marker is O4 and O1. These both are present on the oligodendrocytes, and the significance of both the markers is same, that is cell surface marker on immature developing oligodendrocyte, while the O1 marker, the significance is something different, that is cell surface marker that characterized mature oligodendrocyte. You can see this is a very minute difference between O4 and O1. O4 help in developing oligodendrocytes, while the O1 characterized mature oligodendrocytes. This is early stage and this is later stage. Then you can see here how minute differences can confuse you. Next one is nervous system continuation. Synaptophysin, this is present on neuron, and the significance is that neuronal protein located in synapses This is a neuronal protein and it is present in the synapse and it indicates connection between neurons. What is connection between neurons? If I draw a neuron, although this is a very funny neuron, but you can see I am showing you connection. This is cell body and these are axons, while these are synapse and this is synaptic junction. And for the formation of this synaptic junction, this synaptophysin is responsible. Next one is tau. Tau is present on neurons and this is a type of MAP and helps maintain structure of the axon. What is a structure of axon? If axon develops in this shape, then no one can differentiate them like this any kind of shape. This will be their particular shape and for it responsible marker is tau. Now we are going to see markers that are present in pancreas. So the marker is CK19 or cytokeratin 19. This is present in pancreatic epithelium and the significance CK19 identifies specific pancreatic epithelial cells that are progenitors for islet cells and ductal cells. Coming to our next marker, that is glucagon. This is present on the pancreatic cells and expressed by alpha islet cells of pancreas. Next marker is insulin, again produced by the pancreatic islets and expressed by the beta islet cells of pancreas. You can see the differences. Next one is insulin promoting factor 1 or PDX1. Again, this is present on pancreatic islets and a transcription factor. This PDX1 is a transcription factor and this is expressed by beta islet cells of pancreas. Coming to next marker, that is nestin. Although we have also seen it in the case of neurons, but this nestin that is present in pancreas is different and it functions differently. This nestin is present on the pancreatic progenitors and this is a structural filament protein indicative of progenitor cell lines including pancreatic cells. Next marker is pancreatic polypeptide and cell is pancreatic islet. This is expressed by gamma islet cells of pancreas. Now you can see you have seen all the alpha, beta and gamma cells. Next one is somatostatin that is secreted by pancreatic islet and present only we can say that surface marker of pancreatic islet expressed by the delta islet cells of pancreas. So alpha, beta, gamma, delta, all the cells are present here. Now we are going to see pluripotent stem cell markers. The first one marker is alkaline phosphatase. This is present on embryonic stem cell and embryonal carcinoma cells. This is elevated expression of this enzyme is associated with undifferentiated pluripotent stem cells. After differentiation, they develop into various kinds of cells. So these markers are responsible for identification before differentiation. Next one marker is alpha fetoprotein. The cell type is endoderm. This alpha fetoprotein is protein expressed during development of primitive endoderm. This reflects endodermal differentiation. Next marker is BMP4 or bone morphogenic protein. Guys, again this is very important marker because this is studied on various kind of cells, and also this is a marker that is broadly studied. This is used for mesodermal cells, and this is a growth and differentiation factor expressed during early mesoderm formation and differentiation. Next one marker is Brachyury. Is again important marker for the mesoderm. This Brachyury is a transcription factor important in the earliest phase of mesoderm formation and differentiation. This is also used as the earliest indicator of mesoderm formation. Next one marker for pluripotent stem cells is CD30. Again, very important marker. This is used for embryonic stem cell as well as embryonic carcinoma cell. The CD30 is a surface receptor molecule found specifically on pluripotent stem cells. Next one marker is TDGF1, that is crypto. This marker is for embryonic stem cell and cardiomyocytes. This crypto is gene for growth factor expressed by embryonic stem cells, primitive ectoderm and developing cardiomyocytes. Next one is GATA4 gene for endoderm, and expression increases as embryonic stem cell differentiate into endoderm. Next marker is GCTM2 for embryonic stem cell and carcinoma cells, and this is antibody to a specific extracellular matrix molecule that is synthesized by undifferentiated pluripotent stem cells. Other marker is Genesis, and again very important marker present on embryonic stem and carcinoma cells, and this Genesis is a transcription factor uniquely expressed by embryonic stem cells either in or during the undifferentiated state of PSCs. Next one is germ cell nuclear factor present on embryonic stem cell and carcinoma cell again, and this is a transcription factor expressed by pluripotent stem cells. Next marker is HNF4, that is a hepatocyte nuclear factor 4 for the endoderm. This HNF4 is a transcription factor expressed early in endoderm formation. Next marker is nestin again, but this time this is for ectoderm, neural and pancreatic progenitor together. Significance that this nestin is intermediate filament within cells, characteristic of primitive neuroectoderm formation. Next is NCAM or neuronal cell adhesion molecule for ectoderm, and this is a cell surface molecule that promotes cell-cell interaction. This indicates primitive neuroectoderm formation. coming to our most important factor, that is OCT4, and next one, that is PEX6. This is also very important. So let us first see OCT4, that is present on embryonic stem cell and embryonic carcinoma cells. This OCT4 is a transcription factor unique to pluripotent stem cells, essential for establishment and maintenance of undifferentiated pluripotent stem cells. And next one, PAX6, again for ectoderm, and this is again a transcription factor is expressed as embryonic stem cell differentiates into neuroepithelium. Next marker is SSEA3 and SSEA4, again very important markers in the regenerative medicine. First one is stage specific embryonic antigen 3 and next one is 4. So this 3 is present, these both are present on embryonic stem cell and carcinoma cell, but the function for the 3 is glycoprotein specific. This SSEA3 is a glycoprotein, that is protein attached with glucose. This expressed in early embryonic development and by undifferentiated PSCs, while SSEA4 is a glycoprotein specifically expressed in early embryonic development and by undifferentiated PSCs. The function of both the glycoproteins are same. Next marker is stem cell factor SCF or c-kit ligand. These are present on embryonic stem cell, embryonic carcinoma cell, hematopoietic stem cell and mesenchymal stem cells. These SCF are membrane protein that enhances proliferation of embryonic stem cell and embryonic carcinoma cells, as well as hematopoietic stem cell and mesenchymal stem cells, and these binds with the receptor c-kit. Next marker is telomerase, present on embryonic stem and carcinoma cell, and telomerase is an enzyme uniquely associated with immortal cell lines. Immortal cell lines are cancer-causing cells. Useful for identifying undifferentiated pluripotent stem cells. Next one is TRA160 and TRA181. Both are present on embryonic stem and carcinoma cell, and the function is same for both, that is antibody to a specific extracellular matrix molecule synthesized by undifferentiated pluripotent stem cells. Another marker is a Y-mantin, again very important marker, that is present on ectoderm, neuronal and pancreatic progenitor. The significance is that Y-mantin is intermediate filament within cell. This is characteristic of primitive neuroectoderm formation. Coming to the markers of skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle and smooth muscles. Very first marker is MyoD and PAX7. These two markers are present on myoblast and myocyte. These both MyoD and PAX7 are transcription factors that direct differentiation of myoblast, that is muscle forming cells, into mature myocytes. Coming to the next marker, that is myogenin and MR4. This is for these skeletal myocytes and this myogenin and MR4 are secondary transcription factors. These are required for a differentiation of myoblast from muscle stem cells. Coming to next type of marker, that is myosin heavy chain marker. This myosin heavy chain marker is for the cardiomyocyte. This myosin heavy chain is a component of structural and contractile protein found in cardiomyocytes. Coming to the next one marker, that is myosin light chain. This light chain is present on skeletal myocyte, while you can see here this myosin heavy chain is present on the cardiomyocytes. So let us see myosin light chain that is present on the skeletal myocyte, and this myosin light chain is a component of structural and contractile protein found in skeletal myocytes. So thank you everyone for watching this session. Many other markers are left still, and we will see in our all those markers in our next lecture. And guys, follow ITLS Academy on various social media platforms like Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, WhatsApp and LinkedIn. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel ITLS Academy, and you can press the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever there is an upload. The app of ITLS Academy is also available on Google Play Store. So thank you for watching. Like this video, share with your friends, and also subscribe to our channel ITLS Academy. For any help or query, you can call us on our helpline number 7080 833 450, and you can also reach us through our website www.idlsacademy.com. Thank you very much again everyone for watching this lecture, for watching this session. Stay connected with ITLS Academy.